Batman Dooley back again, baby. You know what I'm here for. Sports, sports, and more sports. That's why you came to my channel, baby. So what we got going on today is some more First Take-ish. You know me. Got a comment on the show I love. See my input. Understand? Is Antonio Brown and Aaron Rodgers gonna be a great connection? Gonna be immaculate. I'm talking about Jerry Montana. I'm talking about Moss Brady. You feel me? You know, the list goes on. Manning Harrison. Okay? Anyways, let's tune into this First Take-ish, baby. Appreciate you for coming to my channel, though. Subscribe, like, if you're new, comment. If you're new, if you're old, who cares? Just comment, okay? Let me know what's up, baby. This is that man. Okay, look, computer wanna freeze up on me, man. You see what happens when you deal with electronics, everybody? Sheesh, man, electronics ain't shit.
Well, you know what's interesting? For me personally, it's the Green Bay Packers. Simply because not only do you have Devontae Adams on the opposite end of the field, on the opposite side of the field, but you have the greatest talent at the quarterback position that I've ever seen in Aaron Rodgers. He's a bad man. I don't care about 6'9 and one last season. I don't care about the struggles that he had. We know that half the season he played injured. We get all of that. But Aaron Rodgers' ability to fling this football at in any place on the football field, deep, outside the numbers, in between the numbers, mid-range, long game, it doesn't matter. Aaron Rodgers is
a bad man. It doesn't matter what your name is.
Bad man. And if you put him with a receiver the likes of Antonio Brown, who I think would be an upgrade from Jordy Nelson in his heyday, as far as I'm concerned, that would give the great Aaron Rodgers the greatest arsenal he has had in all of his years in Green Bay with Devontae Adams combined with Antonio Brown. That's the way that I'm looking at it. It's that simple to me. Green Bay can't get a running game to save their life, so you might as well fling the football about 45 to 50 times. And that is obviously something that would make Antonio Brown incredibly, incredibly happy. And I guarantee you, Aaron Rodgers would be happy as well. I have no problem with it whatsoever. To me, that is the perfect spot for Antonio Brown, Max.
Of all the outrageous down...
I agree, baby. Well, let's talk about how Rodgers has never had a deadly receiver, a receiver the caliber of Antonio Brown, in my opinion. No, I don't want to hear about Jordy Nelson. He was good. No, I don't want to hear about Greg Jennings. He was good. But they are not Antonio Brown. Capisce? Dead man.
Don't write dumb things you have ever said. No, I'm just kidding. I agree with you. I completely agree with you on this one. Antonio Brown with Aaron Rodgers is something, but Stephen A., that's not what I'm here to debate with you about. AB with Aaron Rodgers makes a ton of sense for the reasons you pointed out. Even the fact that when you look at AB's age, I think maybe he only has like another year or two of elite production given what he's done so far and when receivers start to fall off.
Blasphemy!
I you notice I hesitated to use the word cliff. Nevertheless, Rodgers is ready now. AB is ready now. I get it, but it's not AB that the Packers need. There is a stealer that Rodgers could use, and I know we're talking about AB, but there's another guy who could be on the move, and it's LB. Mm-hmm. Le'Veon Bell. Mm-hmm. Can you imagine? Mm-hmm. Aaron Rodgers has never had that.
He's never had that
kind of back.
Nope.
Where the play action would be impossible. You want to see the greatest play action of all time? Watch Aaron Rodgers with Le'Veon Bell. It would be completely unstoppable. Mm-hmm. I'm not denying that you're right. AB is a nice fit in Green Bay. I'm just saying they don't need it. But Le'Veon Bell on that team immediately changes the way you think about that entire franchise.
I think the way you're looking at it, listen, I'm not going to sit up here and summarily conclude that what I'm saying.
Listen, Stephen A., okay? Anyways, hold on, let me get back. Hold on. No, listen, okay? You're wrong. Le'Veon Bell will actually be a bigger input for Rodgers than a wide receiver, in my opinion, because of the play action. There you go, Max. And who the knew you thought football? You knew football, okay? I thought you was just a boxing man. Good shit, Max. Good stuff, baby.
If you have
have a Le'Veon Bell, you're going to run the football effectively, obviously. And you're going to take pressure off of Aaron Rodgers because either you're running the football or you're dipping and dunking it to a Le'Veon Bell. I get that. But I'm thinking along the mindset of Aaron Rodgers, that arm, that accuracy, his ability to extend plays with his feet, et cetera, et cetera. And I'm looking at it from the perspective that Aaron Rodgers would be flinging the football and they'd have an absolute field day. If you've got Antonio Brown and Devontae Adams on the same squad with Aaron Rodgers as opposed to Big Ben Roethlisberger flinging that football, I'm telling you something right now. I don't want to hear about another year left in the career of an Antonio Brown. I'm talking about a legitimate 4 more years with Antonio Brown and Aaron Rodgers together. Without question. Oh,
I don't know about four.
Oh, yes.
I don't think in 3 years.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Absolutely. There's going to be at least a good 3 seasons of production coming out of Antonio Brown with Aaron Rodgers getting him the ball. Please, this is not Big Ben Roethlisberger. This is Aaron Rodgers, California kid himself. Chico, Cal Berkeley, okay? 24th pick of the 2005 NFL draft, okay? Get Antonio Brown or Le'Veon Bell to help this man, Green Bay, okay? And that's that. This Deadman Dooley, we watching First Take, Stephen A., Max Kelvin. I've seen enough of this First Take footage, okay? Like, subscribe, holla, Deadman!